Hello, I'm going to go through the difference between global and local variables in this video and also evaluate both these two types of variables. So let's start with local variables. By the way, this whole lesson relates to subprograms. So we only really have local or global variables relative to subprograms. Here is a definition for a local variable, which misleadingly, we only really ever talk about variables, but this also applies to constants and arrays as well. Right. So variables or constants or arrays first assigned within a subprogram aren't accessible outside of it. That is because they are said to be local to that subprogram. So let me reword that a tiny bit. A local variable is a variable first assigned within a subprogram, and it being local means it is not accessible outside of that subprogram. So here is just a dummy example, pointless subprogram and a calling line and an extra print. Well, what is going to happen when I run this code? Like always, we run it top to bottom. Definitions get ignored initially. So the first proper line to run is this example line here, example bracket, bracket. This is me calling my procedure. So it jumps up, assigns num to be 55, it then prints num. So you would get 55 on screen. However, then our procedure ends and it jumps back down to where it was before, and then continues, so we next print num again. So an identical line to the last one in our procedure, but this time round, I get an error. And I get an error because num is local. It's local because it is first assigned within a subprogram. There is nothing assigning or using num outside of a subprogram. It's first used inside it, therefore it is local to that subprogram and nothing else. So as soon as that subprogram stops executing, as soon as it finishes, that local variable is lost. It's forgotten about, does not exist anymore. And these contrast with global variables, which are variables, but also constants or arrays, which are first assigned outside of all subprograms. Now they are accessible inside all subprograms. They're available everywhere. That's why they're said to be global. So here is a slightly chunkier bit of code, showing code I've shown in previous videos where we're finding the smallest item in an array. I've got a procedure which packages this code. And at the bottom in my main program, outside of all of my subprograms, I've got a line where I am assigning values to an array. Then I'm calling this procedure. I'm calling this procedure using no parameters. However, my procedure is using this array inside the subprogram. And it's able to do this with no errors because this array is global. It was first assigned outside of the subprogram, therefore is available to be used inside it as well. So this code here runs with no errors. One happens to be our smallest element in this array, therefore one gets printed with this print line here. Now I will say at this point that different languages implement global and local variables differently. So this exact example might not work in some languages. It might cause an error. But typically global, first assigned outside, it can be used no bother at all inside because it is available for the entirety of the program. Once it's first assigned, it's good to go for the whole program. It doesn't stop existing midway through like a local variable does. Now I'm saying all this like global is good and local is bad, but really it's the opposite. We do generally want to avoid using global variables. And we'll say a bit more why later, but if you wanted to be a rebel and try and use more global variables than we should, there is a keyword you can put into either Python code or ERL code to force a local variable to behave like a global one. And this is just the word global, which you stick before the identifier. So here is some code which doesn't use the global keyword just yet. We've got a procedure to calculate the perimeter of a rectangle. We're getting user input to give us the values, no parameters here, and we're calculating the perimeter. And width, height, and perimeter here are all currently local variables. And what I've done in my main program is I've called the procedure, then I've tried to include the perimeter variable in this print line. The issue is this has caused an error because currently perimeter is local and I'm trying to access it outside of the procedure. However, I can be a menace and force it to become a global variable by sticking the word global before the identifier. So this is now no longer a local variable called perimeter, it's now a global variable. Width and height are still local, they still couldn't be accessed outside of our procedure, but perimeter now can be, so this code would work, it would print out the perimeter. based on this procedure. Now, you might try and force it to be global in order to output data from a subprogram. We can use global variables to both input data or output data from a subprogram. They're just not the most sensible way of doing things. So what you really should be doing, instead of using a global keyword, is just convert it to be a function and use return instead. Return doesn't create a global variable. What I've done here is try to avoid all global variables by including my calling line inside this print. That's perfectly fine, you can do that. Although the examples I've shown you in previous videos have always assigned a variable like result to be equal to the calling line. That does create a global variable called result, but it doesn't matter so much for now. This code just avoids all global variables. But the point is, instead of using a global keyword, better to keep it local and just use a function instead. So why am I saying this? Why is it generally not so good to use global variables? Well, a slightly practical reason is if we've got global variables, identifiers can't be easily reused, which is not a problem at all in small programs written just by you. But in a massive project with hundreds of thousands of lines of code potentially, we run out of sensible names for variables and arrays and so on. Think how many times I've used num or total or name or age in my examples I've shown you so far. Well, in a massive project, they will get used multiple times in that program. And if they are being used globally, they can't be reused. You need separate variables for each one. So you might have total 55, total 56, total 57, because you need to have separate names for each of these different totals working in different subprograms. So local means we can delete identifiers from memory once they finish being used. A big problem, again, only really relevant in large projects, is because global variables are available everywhere, individual subprograms can accidentally change global variables, and these are called side effects. You might be given a job to code just one subprogram, and you're really, really focused on that one subprogram. However, if a colleague of yours has decided to set a variable to be global, you might be unintentionally using that same identifier in your subprogram. Even if you're trying to use it locally, if your colleague is using it globally, you might change their variable accidentally, which can cause some quite difficult to resolve bugs because it's not always clear what values are being held at any given point. What you really want is each subprogram to be treated like its own individual unit, its own individual mini program. However, the second we start using global variables, suddenly different subprograms get dragged into using the same variable, and it just causes conflict. What you should be doing most of the time, if you want more maintainable code, is to generally stick to using local variables where possible. And instead of using global variables to input or output data, use parameters and returns to output. That prevents global variables needing to get used. Having said all this, we do sometimes choose to use global variables. Often if your variable or your constant or your array is needed by all or a lot of subprograms, then using it globally will reduce repeated code. And in the case of constants, it being a constant does protect you from some of the drawbacks of global variables like side effects, because it can't change by accident. To give you an example of where this might be appropriate, well, something like pi might need to be used by quite a few different subprograms. Therefore, you set it to be a global constant so all of them can use it. It means you don't have to have a parameter called pi in lots of different subprograms, which is a little bit repetitive.